Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Ashley Espinosa. I am an actor, director, and educator, and usually I'm doing my spotlight series titled Actions for Actors, but this week we are having Action for Educators. So as a college professor, I absolutely understand that online classes are the way of the future for many of us. So if you are a musical theater or theater professor, and you are transitioning from an online class from a face-to-face class to an online class, this video is for you. If you missed it last week, I'll link it up here in the cards for you. Check out my video where I described how to take your face-to-face content and turn that into an online content and the four steps you need. After you've gone through those four steps, now you're ready to move forward and take that information and put it into Canvas. So let's jump into my computer and let's create an online course. Hey everyone. Okay, so your eyes are not messing with you. I did switch hair color. Haha. Okay, so I want to take you straight into one of my actual Canvas shells. Now, this is a class that has already completed. I'm not going to show you any personal information for the students because we know confidentiality is key for our students. Now, take a look at, this is the homepage, and remember, this is the end of the class. So this is how it looks at the end. But this is the first page they see. It's this home button over here on the left, okay? So this is the home button. And this is like the landing page that students see every single time they log in. It is a little bit different on the phone. You don't see all of this, but there still is a home page. I always like to have announcements at the top. You'll see here on the left that there's an announcement section that you can go to and you can make different announcements. So you click here and you can do a typed one, or you can even do a video announcement. So what I'll do is I'll go back and forth between doing both. But you want those top three announcements to get onto your home page. So if you go into your settings, you can set that at the very, very bottom. So I'll show you how to do that really quickly. So if you go all the way down to wherever your settings are, depending on what yours looks like, if you go down here to the very bottom at settings, then click more options, and then right here, show recent announcements on course homepage, and you can pick whatever you want on that side. I would do something on this homepage, even if you write something to them and say, welcome, this is a little about me, I'm really excited for this class, this is what you can expect. You could also do a video on this homepage. Sometimes I'll drop a video for them. I'll show you that in a second for another example. So that's the first landing page. You really want to make that nice and clear for them. And you just create a page, and then you click that to be the home page. So when you start this, it will be empty. You'll just create a page and then make that the landing page. The first thing is your lecture content. Now you want to create this in modules here on the left side. You create this by doing different modules within units. Now this is just how I like to do my classes. I always do 4 units, even if it's a quarter or a semester, depending on what school you're at. So I will do units. You can see I have Unit 1, Unit 2, the midterm, Unit 3, Unit 4, and the final exam. And then I even do an end of semester survey for them, so I get feedback from the students that's anonymous, that doesn't count towards their grade. So within each of these, you don't want to create a module for everything. You really want to keep it organized for the students. So you're taking your lecture content, and the first, you know, if it's the first quiz or the first unit, I like to break it down this way. So you have Unit 1. I have a list here that starts them off. So goals, objectives, and readings. So I make it organized and clear. Okay, again, I'm always using pictures and photos. So I set the goals for the week so they can easily see it before they start. And this is just a page, you just click edit. And then I set the objectives for the week and then what they're reading and the dates so they know. Okay, and then you can't see it, but there's a little button down here. I'll move my face, that clicks next. So then when they click next, it literally stays within that module and they go to the next page within that unit, okay? Again, you don't want them clicking in and out everywhere. And you can see this is a page down here that I just created. So if they go in module 1, they start with the objectives and the readings, and then they keep clicking next and it takes them through the entire unit. So they're staying within that one little section, that one little module. So I like to break it down and I put my lectures in here. So the first part of this lecture, the way I taught it this quarter or this semester was, starting out with creating the environment in that chapter. And I put my little lecture notes from my slides in here. And then I will also put in here video clips. Now, I would suggest utilizing YouTube because it gives you the option of closed caption, which is accessible to our students. It's the best way to do it. Also, it's not using memory by uploading videos. So you really want to make them from YouTube. If it's not from somebody's page here that I pulled, put it on your own YouTube channel. You want to put all of that in here so it's easy to read and it's accessible to them. Okay, so let me go back. You have that first page. And then I create the lectures for them. That was like a starting page. And then I create the lectures. And then you can see as they click through and keep clicking next, it takes them to a proscenium stage. And then I have a video on the proscenium. So here's a breakdown of it, some pictures of it. And then if they click next, let me see if it'll work with inside this. Yes, it will. When they click next, it goes to the video that I want them to watch of a proscenium stage. Okay, and then they just keep clicking next as they go through the lecture, if you will. Arena stage, I have videos, photos, and they literally just keep clicking through so they don't have to click in and out. I will warn you, and you may not realize this until you start teaching, a lot of students will do this on their cell phone. A lot of them will not use a desktop computer. They will use a cell phone. So you want to make it accessible for them so they can easily read it. Okay, and I have it all broken down here. Again, they're just clicking next to get through all of this because all of these little lectures and videos are in Unit 1, right here, all within Unit 1. So taking that lecture content and putting it into a readable form. Now, as you can see, I don't have audio ones in this lecture, but at the top, what I would do is, so if this is a part of my lecture, I would put the audio clip, let me move my face back over here. I would put my audio clip up here at the very top so they could just click on it. But I don't have an audio clip in this one. And then I have my photos and videos and my text. So the students are getting everything in this one module. Easy for them and accessible for them. At the very end of every unit, which I call separate modules, I do a discussion post for them and then a quiz. And then a little checklist as a reminder. This is all again in this one module. And when you create these separate pages, you can make them quizzes, you can make them, you know, whatever you want. So this goes into the engagement solution. So the number two section. So you wanna have engagement with them. This is an example of one of my discussion posts. I will literally give them the topic and then I will give them questions that I want them to do. And then I will say what they have to impose, what they need to include. I only did one student response. Usually I respond to two students. Tips for success. You always want to give them all of the information in an easy, digestible form. Don't give them huge paragraphs. Do bullet points. Okay, and then I'll give them a little bit about the video that I'm going to watch. This was a video, so I had them watch this video and then respond with a discussion. And then this video, respond with a discussion. And in this one, I think I let them pick. Yeah, they can select either Hamilton or Phantom, and then they're going to post about these questions. All right, so I put the videos right in here. It's all within Canvas. They can literally click, watch it, but at the very bottom, they click reply, and then it starts to post. I also set it up in the settings where when you're editing this page, that they have to reply, they have to post their initial response, and then after they post their initial response, it shows all of the other replies. So they can't just see them and then copy somebody's. All right, so discussion post, you really wanna make sure you lay that out. So there's a discussion post at the end of every module. You can see down here, you don't want discussion, and then there's a quiz, okay? And you can go in and do the quiz for them right over here on the side, but again, I put that after I created, I put it within the module, and then you can see all the information. I give them a little breakdown here, what it's covering, how long they have, and I put a little fun quiz for them, right? So make sure, again, your content is within units and modules. You're doing a discussion post either every week or within every unit, and then you're ending it with some type of quiz. So again, they can go over here to quizzes on the left, and they can see all the quizzes and exams that they have. But I also put that within the module so they can literally just click, keep clicking through, and they're gonna see everything and not miss it. Now, you can notice here at the end of every module or every unit, as I break it up, I do a checklist. This is really helpful for the students. Make sure they don't miss anything. So I said, did you read those? Did you watch those? Did you post the discussion? Did you leave a reply discussion or two replies? And did you take the quiz? If so, great, you can move on to unit two. And they click next and it takes them straight to unit two. The next thing is about quizzes and exams. You can go over here and create different quizzes, different exams for them, different types. So here's unit one quiz, also a midterm and a final exam. So midterm is also going to be very much longer. This would be blank. All you would do is click edit, and then it takes you into, this won't be here, of course. You can put, you know, little fun things in here, makes it a little more exciting for them. And then go down here and you can check off what you want. Make sure you're really specific with these. You want to assign it to everyone. You want to give the dates that it's available for them. And then when you go in after that, you can go back to the top and you can pick questions. And then it gives you answers. You can edit it on the side. You can do true and false, multiple choice, all that jazz. You can click if you want to show question details, all that. Goodness. Put your grade in, how long you want it to be, how many points you want it to be, and it will automatically be graded for them. Shuffle the answers, how long you want it to be. All of that is in here. You just have to dig. Now, if you have a student that needs more time, and I can't go into this because it would show you their personal information, but if you have a student that needs more time, like they are registered with Student Abilities or Disability Services and they need more time, you need to go in, and there's a way that you can do this. You go in to the settings of the students, and I can't show you because it'll show their personal information, but you can go under the people, which is down here, and you can go in and you can actually edit for each person individually more or less time. I can't show you how to do that exactly because it'll show their personal information. But if you need that, let me know in a comment below and I'll see if I can just talk you through it. And four is essay papers and research. So this is in another class. This is not an online class right now, but I utilize it quite often. So under assignments, this is musical theater history. Since it's a face-to-face class, the exams are very simple. What I like to do is a research paper. So a research paper or a critique, a performance critique if you so choose to. This is again very simple because it's a face-to-face class. So I have them write a 5 to 6 page research paper on a chosen artist that we cover in the quarter, and then they submit it on here. So what you want to do is go into edit after you create this, the assignment originally. So under assignments, you would create a paper or a quiz or whatever. And then I put a group grade, and then they're gonna submit this online. So you wanna put online, and then they're gonna do a file upload. And then I don't usually do restricted files or anything like that, but a file upload, assign it to the entire class and when it is due. So it's due the end of this year. I leave it open for them if I want to allow them to turn it in at any time. If you want to only give them a window that it's open to turn in, then you would put available from and until. Those are the only days that it would be open or closed. So what this does is it allows them to upload a PDF. So here's an example from a performance-based class where I require them to do a paper. So like they do an analysis paper. This could be your critique, this could be your performance, this could be your research paper, whatever writing you want. I make them do a song analysis paper, and then they have to upload the PDF file. So let me show you an example of what it looks like. You would click SpeedGrader, and then I'm gonna edit out their names. So you would click SpeedGrader, and then you see all of their information over here on the left side, their paper. It looks just like the PDF document. And then what you can do is you can go in and you can say, oh, Sister Mary Robert. Oh, this is, you know, you could type over here. Great idea. Love this thought. Or you're incorrect. Maybe check this out. Here's another great example of the beginning of a homepage. This is a face-to-face class I'm teaching right now. Again, very simple. Here's another example of a homepage that I'm teaching at another school. So if you look on the landing page, I have like the logo of the school, I have my name, take a look around, and then I have like the department information, ah, funny video here. So you can put that within here as well. What I like to do, even if you are teaching a class that doesn't utilize Canvas, it utilizes Canvas, but it's not online. What I like to do is I will still create a module. So for example, I just started this one right now at UCI, but I like to do an overview. So I'll do an overview page, and then any specific PDFs that I really want them to focus on, I will put those links in here, and then they can click next, and then they can click over to the videos that they're gonna view outside of class. So here's the videos, I put the links in here, YouTube is accessible, and again, it has a closed caption on it, and that way they can easily see it and there's not a lot of question. It has been an amazing asset to a class that's face-to-face for the students to be able to access all the information. So you can even do that as a module over here as just a basic outline, right? So this is just unit one for that they're working on right now. And it gives the students an idea of what I'm covering, but without giving them everything so they still come to class. So anywho, I hope those answer your basic questions. If you need anything else, please let me know. And if you need more videos like this, let me know in the comments below what you need exactly, and I will make little videos for them. Have a great time, everyone. Thanks for watching. Now that you have the tools to not only build your online class, but to take that information and put it into Canvas, go forth and take the actions you need to gain progress in your career as an educator. Have a great week. Take the actions you need to gain progress in your career. Bye.